something noteworthy that happened to you this week? It was a whole week. Gotta be something.
I heard a rough week over here. What happened?
I got my period.
Gotcha.
So, the first time I remember getting hard was I was at a Hudson Valley Renegades game. So I grew up in Poughkeepsie, New York, for the first 8 years of my life. And so we'd go to the games all the time, and I just frankly remember a couple outside like the popcorn line just making out very intensely. And I hadn't seen tongue-on-tongue action before. So I got my first boner, and I'll always remember that. Thank you, Hudson Valley Renegades.
Miss Lane was my first teacher crush. She was my ninth grade history teacher, and it's notable that she was very pregnant at the time. And I think there was something like internally primal about that too. I was just like, Miss Lane's kind of going on. I got horrible grades in that class because like my new 13-year-old prepubescent mind was just going crazy. It's like, oh, the War of 1812, but like, do you really love your husband? Because I've got feelings, Miss Lane. And then, so she was that teacher that like the whole high school career I thought for some reason I had a chance. And so it's like, I'm like the senior in high school. I was like, hey, Miss Lane, remember me? I'm just going to hang out on your off period during my lunch.
The first time I ever came into contact with the female period, I was dating this woman, and we were doing things, and I was very new, and I was down there, and all of a sudden, my entire arm is covered in blood. I thought I did something very bad. I found out later, of course, she started her period, and it was fine. But the awkward part was I had to go ask my mom for a tampon.
The first time I ever got rushed to the hospital, it's nothing like super interesting or anything. I was just like cutting holes in a costume that I was gonna wear for a costume party. It was like in second grade, so I had a big pair of scissors. Probably should have used safety scissors, but they can't cut through sheets like normal scissors. So I was cutting the holes, had my finger there, cut right into my finger, didn't notice that I had cut into my finger until I put the sheet down, noticed there's a bunch of red on it. So I walk over to my mom, I'm like, Mom, I think I cut myself. I think I might have a paper cut. I don't know how I got it. She looks at the scissors, she looks at me, and she's like, get in the car right now. We are going to the hospital. Because it's been all the way down my hand. All the way down my hand.
So on a note that's other than my boner, the first time I broke my arm, I was playing catcher in a little league, and so the umpire was kind of, he was pushing me closer and closer to the plate as the game went on, and so eventually one of the batters hit my glove, and so I said something to the umpire, I was like, can you back off me a little bit? But he didn't, so I kept getting closer and closer until I stuck my arm out a little bit too far, and whack! Broke my arm. I started crying.
So after Miss Lane told me that her marriage was going great, I moved on to Miss Rogers, who was on the same hall, very convenient for me. She was younger, she was a special education teacher, and I would go in there and just get a bunch of candy from her, and so every lunch period, she was my new boo, 12th grade, I was graduating soon, I'm 18, Miss Rogers. Like, you're single, Miss Lane is boring with a husband. Notice me.
So then I got to college, and I had this one professor. He was 1 year away from retirement, but I was like, oh, what's up, Mr. Jenkins? How's it going? And every day after class, I'd stay late just trying to see what I could do to get maybe some office hours. He was not biting.
So I remember my first murder. I asked my mom for a tampon afterwards because it was super bloody and it was super awkward too because I had never murdered before. And I was like, Mom, can I get one of them tampons? She's like, oh my god, are you dating again? I was like, no, I killed for the first time. She's like,
so after college, I got on the online dating apps and I set my age range because I'm into older women. I set it from 40 to 80 years. And I'm getting a lot of hits. There's a lot of women who are into me, a young man, a young stud, as I like to call myself. Yeah, that's all I got for you right now.
So, obviously I was very deterred from making costumes in the future, but around the time I was in my mid-20s, I decided to go to Comic-Con and do the costume thing again. This time, however, I would not do anything that took scissors, so I just had this very blocky costume that had no definition at all.
I remember when I broke my first boner. It was also during a baseball game. I didn't wear a cup per my coach's suggestion, so I was rock hard at the plate, right? And I was looking at that home run, right? And I got so excited. And then when I swung and missed, for some reason the catcher just still went out and punched and broke my boner. It was super embarrassing.
Oh, I remembered screams of murder victim that. Oh man, really, really, really. Minute Maid stuff with like the prune juice.
I also see nothing wrong with dating older women because they love younger men. And so if any younger men don't know, there is an untapped market, y'all. I set my Tinder.
Don't give them the information. Don't give them the information.
I'm a free space right in the middle. Pick me.
Pick me.
Oh shit, I got a match. Gertrude. Grandmother of seven. Grandma?
Alright. You sure you can pitch?
One. I was a major leaguer back in the day.
All right, but just look, okay?
Yeah.
Storybook situation, bottom of the ninth, two outs. That's your batter. Do you recognize him? It's your grandson.
Sup, motherfucker?
Oh, that's Sean.
Oh, now you remember. You remember during Christmas, though.
Right, don't listen to him. Don't listen to him. You can do this, all right? I'm going to take this. All right. Here's your glove.
Make sure you give him that Cialis, too. He's going to need it.
Here we go.
All right, time out. Time out.
You get the fuck off the field. Yeah, it's Little League, Grandpa.
Get up! You can do it! You can do it! You got it!
Another shot.
Luckily, you got a whole pile of them right there.
He did it. It left his hand that time.
That's a strike. That's
we
a strike.
Got it, Grandpa.
Grandma's got it.
She's not.
She's
gone.
She's
it's
not.
Fine.
She's like, no, away. She probably, she's out. Win or lose, she won't see it.
Thanks, Dad.
Sean, can you just swing at this one no matter where it goes? I really need this for my confidence.
Just do it. Just do it, okay? Otherwise, you'll do it. You can do it.
Emma, listen.
Yeah.
I respect it. I respect it. I don't respect that. But pitching like this, it's not gonna bring her back. Just I need to go
just
out there.
Like he threw it at you.
He send him home.
You hit him. Okay.
Send him home.
Just pretend, okay?
Just do this.
Now you're gonna have another Great Depression.
Alright, see, Alice is kicking in, I gotta go.
God, I am not ready to talk to you right now.
I love it when you talk to me like that.
I really need a break from all of this, okay? Okay?
Tell me everything.
Like, I'm burned out at work. Like, my boss yells at me the minute I get there. And then when I try to put in all those actuary reports, like, he still yells at me. He's like, David, you really, really could have done a much better job at this.
You paid for an hour, and you're burning that hour real quick.
And it's
real
just,
quick.
And it's just like my 6 month review was yesterday, and he was just like, you know,
you could
improve. You could really like. You could really just try to improve morale just a little bit, you know. Like, don't bring the team down by being so mopey all the time. And try to get all of your work done before 5 o'clock, so you don't have to work so much. You don't have to work overtime so much.
This genuine song's gonna end soon, so if you wanna cash up.
And then when he says things like,
I can't work like this.
You're not gonna get promoted.
Mercedes, I'm sorry. I didn't know we had such a broken man.
I charge double for broken men. And I charge triple for big deep stuff.
That is your first of four teams. For the second team, please give a big round of applause for Kites Are Fun! Something else that's fun.
Basketball.
Coach, I don't care if I'm short. You gotta put me in. Please, Coach. My grandparents are here.
Bruce, we've been over this. We're gonna wait until we've got a minute left, and then if we're up by 20, you can't dribble in the middle of the game. It's confusing. You have to sit on the bench. Bruce, come on.
Coach, please, I'm trying to show you how athletic I am.
Bruce, I've seen a lot. Bruce.
Put the head energy, please.
Sorry. Time out.
We're going to get... Call time out, Coach? Take a knee, Coach?
Sure, Bruce. Warm me down.
What? Wait. I'm ready.
Okay. Yeah, they got me on Ritalin, so, you know, recess has been super chill ever since.
Welcome to the club.
What do they give you?
I only know Ritalin.
Dude,
yeah. Did you wanna play King of the Jungle?
I'd love to.
Alright, I'm gonna climb up. Can you just hang out here for a second?
Yeah, I like having some pretty mediums, if you know what I mean.
Can I just tell you to calm down, please?
I didn't mean Bill, to get aggressive.
Fill up your medication. I learned the hard way.
Well?
Yeah, I blew out my candles too fast during my birthday, and apparently there was a line.
I'm having a hard time concentrating. Can I get a new dose? New dose?
You get yours delivered.
New dose! I'm getting hyper over here!
Right. There can only be one king of the jungle.
That would work! That could be my wrestling persona, you're right! King of the jungle! So it's like a gorilla suit thing?
Absolutely. We want to go in and strike fear into the other opponents in that ring.
Alright, cool. Like, ooh, King of the Jungle! I need to have a signature move, though.
Absolutely. I will say your signature move probably shouldn't be to smile so much. It's not very intimidating.
Oh, okay. I can't help it. This is too much fun.
Okay, we can channel that, but I don't know. Think of an unhappy memory. Is there a time when maybe you didn't get something for your birthday that you wanted?
Well, I grew up white, upper, middle class in the suburbs of Chicago.
Okay. Strike that. Yeah, you are still way too happy. I mean, this is a bloodthirsty sport.
I would wrestle, but I hurt my knee long ago.
So, how about this? Have you ever been physically injured? Like, did you fall off your bike when you were little?
Well, my spotter when I went rock climbing in third grade.
Hold on. That's not even relatable. Part of this is, not only do you have to be fierce, but you have to be relatable. People want to root for you.
Jane, no good?
We do this every night. Why can't you just sit and have a conversation? I get it, you're super strong, you are the king of the jungle, but come on.
Jane.
Tarzan.
I try to talk and you correct grammar. It's very, very insulting.
Okay, so this is good. We're having a conversation. Well, this is great.
Good. Also, you leave hair all over jungle floor.
I don't know. I think I'm ready to really experiment, you know? Like, yeah, I've kind of just rocked the same style for years. I'm open to suggestions. Hey, Tom. I need some style tips here, man.
Oh, sorry, bro. You look great.
What is going on? Tom, ever since you started DJing, being a friend to you has been a super drag. How much room your turntables take up, man? This is valuable breakfast nook space.
This is my career, man.
Your career?
Yeah.
Since we've lived in this apartment, your career has been barista, short order cook, gig economy guy.
Birthday parties, magician at birthday parties, now I'm a DJ.
Tom, I can't believe you're moving out of the group house. God, this is, you know, sad for us, but I'm so happy for you that you're getting your own studio apartment.
Tom! Sorry, bro, what's up?
What I'm trying to tell you is
you look great.
I'm trying to tell you you're living the millennial dream. You know, aspirational, but also kind of depressing. This is your last box. Are you going to pack up your DJ table too? Or you want to carry that in your lap?
Wait, kicking me out?
Tom, I told you, this house isn't big enough for you. We got you a nice place. It's 300 square feet.
Plus, we got this new Nintendo Switch.
That's right.
And we need room for that.
Mm-hmm. It takes a lot of movement room, and your DJing is just all elbows.
Tom, are you gonna cry? Tom, don't cry. Well, you can still have your gigs. You can invite us on Facebook. We'll come to your gigs.
Sorry, bros, I'm new and I'm not wanted anymore.
Yeah, yeah, you're sorry, you're not wanted. We've been trying to.
So this guy, he's like a part lab. He wasn't wanted.
Yeah, does match the description.
What are your reservations?
I don't know.
I'm extremely picky. I know that we shouldn't go like puppy mill or whatever, but
I've been researching. Have you seen my Pinterest board for dogs? I printed it out. I'm not just gonna, I mean, yes, sad look, no one has bought this dog or adopted this dog in years, but I'm not just gonna jump on it. That's not where my heart is right now.
Okay, well, how about, there's a corgi, it's a corgi. You love corgis?
Corgis are on, like, page 3. I'm not gonna say no, but I'm not just gonna rush into a decision. Hold on, let's see. Is it connected to the royal lineage at all?
it says here it came from that tornado in Oklahoma. It's like a refugee.
This is the biggest decision we've made as a couple. It has to be right.
You're right. Because if this isn't right, then my idea of us moving to Oklahoma isn't going to be right.
Wait, what?
Jim, look, you've been a great owner.
Yeah.
you know, you've been walking me for 3 years now. It's like 21 of my years. I give you feedback. Feedback a little bit.
Fire when ready, Roxy.
First off, let me finish before you pull out the bag.
I know you're cooped up all day,
yeah.
And it's just something we're both anticipating.
I feel rushed, okay? You go in. Watch you. You go into the bathroom with a book. You take your time.
Yeah, that's what humans do.
Advice number 2?
Yeah.
You sure you're ready? I feel like you're getting a little...
No, Roxy, this is important. I value these talks.
Things that are in a bone shape, don't fool me.
You'd rather have a real bone. You know those will hurt your teeth.
Come on, evolution.
What about squeaky toys?
No, squeaky toys I like. I'm sorry. I should start with something positive. Squeaky toys I like. Bones, not fooling me. Let me end it with something positive. Is that okay?
I don't get it. Am I getting fired here?
Come out, I'm sorry.
No!
I can hear you pacing around. You're still upset.
This is my tap dance. I'm not gonna ruin practice because you made me upset.
Hey.
What?
Listen for a sec. You sound great, okay?
Really?
Yeah. I actually think you're the best dancer in the troupe.
Then why did you shush me?
It's my own insecurity, okay? It's actually...
You think you can defeat me, Tapper?
Oh my god, King of the Jungle! You know what, I'll lightly dance circles around you.
Round 1.
Guys, come back to the bench for a second, okay?
That really hurt.
Sorry.
Guys, this is...
You know it's all fake, right? This is why I hesitated to put you in. You were taking this so seriously.
I practice for an hour every day. What do you mean it's fake?
And I brought real banana peels. It wouldn't hurt you to slip on one.
We have a whole prop department for that. We want it to look real. We want it to feel real, but our insurance cannot cover it.
Even this nosebleed? Oh, that I had that before.
All right, I'll
let's try it again. I'll be gentle.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Whoops!
Please give a big hand for your third competing team, On the Wire.
The only thing we need to get started is a feeling, an emotion, something, you know, a word.
Happy.
Happy. Happy.
Happy.
That's a great one. I like that. Happy.
So I can't tell you what the happiest moment of my life is, but I can tell you what the worst moment of my life is. When I was trying to score points with my girlfriend at the time, and so I went home to a Christmas dinner to meet her family. And it was a pretty good dinner and stuff like that, and conversation was flowing. I thought I was scoring points left and right. I was like, all right, I'm like gonna be in this family. This is great. And we were sitting down to dinner, and I thought, this would be a great time to pull out this epic story about when I was in Chicago. I knew this guy I worked with, and he didn't have dental insurance, and so he had a cavity. So instead of taking out just one of his teeth, he took out all of them so he didn't have to deal with anything, like you do. And so I decided to tell that at the dinner table, and I was like, Mrs. Steinbach, this is, this happened to me, and the room fell silent. And my girlfriend at the time turned to me, and she told me, I told you that my mother did the same thing when she was younger. So I'm single now, and...
before you go in, I just, before you meet everyone, I just want to let you know, hey, look at me. It's probably going to be hard, I'm sorry.
You're not really reassuring.
I just want to give you like a background on everyone. So my mom, okay?
Okay.
Don't look at her mouth, she doesn't have teeth. She doesn't like it when you look at her mouth, she's looking straight in the eye.
Does not have teeth?
No, she does not.
I just want to let you guys know that dinner's served, okay?
Thanks, Mom. Thanks, Mom.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Wow, you did an extremely bad job.
She didn't have teeth.
That's what I said. Okay, that's a warm-up. Don't worry. Just next time,
Okay.
You're really cool.
Okay.
You're all
right, next person.
Yeah. Okay, so my dad, just, don't look like head up because, there's just no skin, and I'm sorry. There's hair, but there's no skin.
Hey, okay. Just want to tell you, I just found a really good TV show tonight that I thought we could all watch together.
Okay, yeah, okay.
What's he doing? What's he doing?
Oh, he's
what's
just,
he doing?
Listen,
is your head okay? It looks a little bit sensitive.
Hey, you know what? Yeah. Hey, Dad, yeah, we'll talk about the TV show tonight. Yeah. No.
Just a bad sunburn. Okay?
Yeah.
An Irish guy.
Sometimes when you work the seas too long, you start going a little stir crazy.
I'm telling you. I've been out here now for, what's it been? 2 months? Who? Start seeing things out there in those waves.
I know. All I can taste is salt now. Just the salt water in my mouth, the salt water out of my mouth.
Well, Joseph, we told you not to drink the salt. It's bad for you.
Well, you know, it's just you stop thinking about all the...
Hey, are y'all working down there?
I'm working.
We're working. Don't worry about us. I'm doing the sweeps.
I don't know. It looks like he's sitting.
I'm in the middle of a...
Let him be. He just finished 2 cups of seawater. Get him.
When I come back in 5 minutes, you better be working.
Okay. Well, you better get... Take your broom. We gotta keep sweeping this place.
I know. I just...
You didn't know how much dust there is on the sea.
I thought that I could take...
Where is it all coming from?
I thought it could take 2 minutes of my time just to have a thoughtful little monologue to myself on this ship. But that's the problem with this ship. We never get time for ourselves anymore.
Thoughtful monologues are on the other deck. You're going to want to go back there to get the thoughtful monologue. So, yeah. Sorry.
Well, you know me. With the amount of seawater I drank, my legs are shaking because I'm so dehydrated. I can't make it to the other deck.
Well, fine. Go. What do you have to say?
Thank you.
I'm sorry, you're sitting down.
We're working. Hey. I don't want to get, I'm a little nervous, but,
I can see that.
Yeah, no, yeah. But, yeah, no, this is my first time in a Target, and I've heard so many good things, so. I'm kind of freaking out a little.
Yeah.
I saw the Target on your ship,
yeah.
So I'm assuming you work here.
I can
you help me?
I can, but you're gonna need to tell me what you need.
Yeah, I don't know, I came in here to get a towel, and now, this whole cart is, full of things, that I don't even remember getting.
I'm sorry, I'm just a little overwhelmed. I thought, you know,
I
walked into a Best Buy and then you showed me a TV. It's just been a big day, okay? It's been a big freaking day.
Yeah, this is just our starter TV.
Oh my god. You don't have HD, do you?
Of course, all our TVs have
HD. Oh. Excuse me, I always get like this when there's excellent customer service.
You understand?
Have I
showed you our DVD?
So when I think about being happy, I guess, I think about, you know, being in like middle school and playing softball, on the B team. There's nothing like being on a B team, middle school team, because it's all the like real soft kids who like, you know, like just kind of want to be out in the field and like make daisy chains and just like are nice to each other. Like zero effort, like no stakes, like, and all the parents like come to the games and they're like, we're just, you know, whoever hits the ball, that's gonna be exciting. So, my team is like full of like all the kids whose like parents wanted them to do sports, but they just like weren't super interested. And we all like would get together like before the games and like instead of warming up would be like, you know, just like either like singing songs in the field or like we were just too whimsical for softball. you know, and that's why I'm the person I am today, not a softball player.
Whistle while you work.
Work while you whistle. I think we're doing a little bit too much work, guys. You know, I don't want to get like too tired before the game. Just yeah, no, take a break, relax. It's just
soft. God.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. That's very relaxed.
Guys, I don't want to make you think I like prepared, but I had like 4 popsicles before I got on the field today. I know. I heard it was like.
Do you have any more?
No.
You're gonna have to pee so bad up there. That's so cool. Yeah. No, I mean like I'm excited for the game because like I think today's the day that like maybe I'll like not be, you know, scared enough and to hit the ball. I get really scared about making contact, so I usually just, you know.
Jenny, you should be less hard on yourself. You know your first at bat, you got beat in the head.
I just never been the same since I got the, you know, old softball to the head. Went from A to B, you know? But, you know, I feel a lot better with you guys. It's a more docile crowd.
Somebody once told me I was gonna roll me.
That's the kind of stuff I'm
I got
now,
this
yeah.
Five softball on the head.
Thank you. Yes.
Jen, you should be really less hard on yourself. I remember when you got back to your second at bat that day, you looked so tough. You were ready to just have the greatest redemption, and then boom, right in the head.
And right in the head. Yeah, they sent me back out there because, you know, they thought that maybe I had a little bit more in me, and I didn't, you know.
But everybody saluted you in that ambulance out, girl. You were incredible.
That was fun. I do like ambulance rides. They're pretty fun, yeah. Well, I don't know. It seems like it's starting to like... You are full of songs. I love it.
Yeah, they call me the human karaoke.
I love you guys. Well, okay, 2 minutes, then, I don't know, I guess more popsicles just like right before we start?
Of course, of course.
Sounds great.
Okay, guys. You're great.
Performance is just not relegated to the stage. It's everywhere.
I don't like that. No. No. I don't like that. I didn't want everyone knowing about my cast, and now everyone does. I don't know. I don't think I can stay in this class anymore. I'm sorry. This was like a little too much.
This is the only way you're gonna get over stage fright, okay? Just like when Johnny, he was afraid of taking planes, and then we took him to the airport, and he was screaming and yelling the entire time, saying, "Please don't make me do this." Guess what? He's now still in shock, but we're getting better. It's just jump into the fire, Janice. Jump into the fire now.
I took this class just like being, you know, like a more confident person, and like this has made me feel increasingly less confident, I would say. I don't know. Can we just like, do I have to look at them?
Oh, yeah, it's best just to get right into their eyes and just look at them deeply. Try to figure out what the audience is feeling right now.
Okay, I'm getting to it. This isn't working!
No, not him. He's empty.
Oh, okay. It's still not working!
He's even more empty than the guy.
Please clap.
I think it's working. I mean, but I've seen it now. I think I can handle it.
Okay, I'm ready, but I just want to say, I do have a cousin, okay, who's going to be there as well. I don't want you looking like, I need you looking like neck down,
sure.
Because their face is a parrot's face.
Okay. I think I can prepare myself.
Yeah, don't
cousins,
just like...
Cousins are easier than parents.
Okay, yeah.
Like, it's not a die... moment,
yeah.
Like, it's just, you know, it's your cousin.
It's my cousin.
Yeah.
Okay, right behind you.
Okay.
Ready, set, go.
I think the happiest I think I've ever felt was just this last Friday. I quit my job of a year and a half, and it felt great. Right? There is nothing like walking out into the bevy of unemployment, quite like quitting your job, but seeing all the stresses kind of melt away. But even better is walking by the cubicles of people still there and their eyes darting up going, "I wish I was you, I wish I was you." But then there's that little stress that happens, right? Like, happiness is a weird thing because it happens in like fits and starts, and there's only like a little bit there, and you have to grab onto it, because by the time you grab onto it, it's gone. That's why I always think that's kind of cool about happiness, right? Is that it's not like constant.
Alright, so we've got three competitors down. You've got your final competing team. Before the headliners coming up now, please welcome Working On It! Woo! Yeah.
gonna do a show for you. You've seen three, you're gonna see a fourth one now. Can we get a non-geographic location? Anywhere, just a non-
What's that?
The Metro.
The Metro.
Thank you. Dylan? Dylan? Rosa.
Sorry, what?
It's Rosa.
Rosa, right?
I'm for sure, yeah.
Hey, Dylan. Hey, it's good to see you.
I don't need to shake your hand, I know you.
Oh, okay. Sorry, it's just been so long.
Yeah, it's been like 20 years.
So you're still in DC, huh?
Yeah, well, you know, I moved to Michigan to go to high school because my dad had another job, and then we moved to Chicago because then his job changed again, and then I went to Texas for college,
okay,
Texas A&M, Longhorns, and then now I'm back here for an internship.
Okay. Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good. Yeah, no, I never really left DC.
What?
Yeah, that's about it. Thanks for all the details. That was pretty cool. Where are you writing to?
Graduate.
You going to Glenmont?
Eventually I'm gonna. I have to go to work first. I'm gonna go to Capitol Hill, and then after that I'm supposed to meet my friend at DuPont. But then I live out in Glenmont right now, so eventually I think I'm gonna take the H8 to Glenmont, and then I'll probably walk to my house from the bus stop, which is about a 15-minute walk. We have a great location.
I'm going to Glenmont. It's cool.
What do you do these days?
I work mostly. I'm on a kickball team, which is pretty cool.
What?
Yeah.
Wow. I signed up for sign up if you're interested in doing kickball team.
Oh, it's my stomach. There you go. You could have shown a lot more hustle out there.
I know.
I'm
sorry, I didn't mean to sound indignant when I said that.
It's fine. I know coaches aren't a real thing here on the kickball league. It's a social league. We're here to have fun.
No. I mean, it's fun to win. So.
Yeah, it's more than fun to win. Winning is everything.
I know! I'm not arguing that point with you!
Okay, I'm glad we both understand that winning is the most important aspect of a social kickball league.
Listen. Social energy goes into showing Darwinism socially, where you're the best of the best. Does that make sense?
Yeah, you don't have to bring your work side of things into this, okay?
I know you're in
evolutionary biology, but you don't have to bring this onto the field, okay? I just want to win!
I know! We're in agreement!
Cool. I just think you could have really like pursued those line drives, you know, all of those.
Oh.
They were just like line drives straight out in the outfield that you could have like, you know, shown some hustle for.
I could have hustled, yeah.
You want to see your hustle? Your hustle was like, it got by me, guys. Sorry, I'll buy the first round. That's not hustle.
I just think that you're very right now.
You know, you can ride all the way up to the Washington Monument. Bet you didn't know
like
that.
Like take the escalator. You can get off the metro stop and you can get...
And then you get in the elevator. Yeah, you don't take an escalator up to the top of the Washington Monument.
I mean, I have never been in there, so I wouldn't know.
It's just...
I wouldn't
it's
know.
Something you might not know.
Oh, okay, so... You're full of fun facts, Tony. you're full of fun little tidbits.
Yeah.
I love it. It's fun.
Yeah, I know.
You're fun.
Yeah.
You're a fun guy.
What about the nation's capital?
You've been living here for 6 months and you know everything. I'm so impressed.
I took a tour. You know, they told me a lot. You know the Jefferson Memorial?
Yeah, wasn't that the one with Jefferson?
Yeah, that's what they call it, the Jefferson. You know that sometimes they throw like little pop-up raves in there?
What?
Yeah, it's like real.
That seems...
Yeah, you gotta be in on the
holy
DL
shit.
With that. But
what kind of chaos are they doing in DC?
Sorry, what was that?
I said, what kind of chaos are they doing in DC?
Yeah, that's actually what they call the raves. They're chaos raves. They're pretty
chaos in
pretty
DC.
Slick.
Good
pretty
lord.
Slick.
Good lord.
There's a lot of pretty edgy nightlife here on the,
Listen,
National Mall.
I came here all the way from Tallahassee. my brain wasn't ready for all this. I mean, I'm worried you're gonna change. There's all this, like, fancy city life. I mean, you still gonna be the same boy from Tallahassee? Are you gonna change?
I'm still the same. I'm just into some, you know, different stuff. I wander around the mall aimlessly now. I go to raves at the Jefferson Memorial.
I noticed that you have...
I shoot up drugs in the Lincoln Memorial, right on his lap. It's a whole thing. I'm not the same boy from Tallahassee.
I'm willing to respect that, but what concerns me is I noticed that you have 3 black jackets for rain.
Yeah,
and
I got my leather jacket, I got my black hoodie, and then
and
I got a black track jacket underneath it.
I feel like your soul is turning a little black from all the politics up here.
It's,
The drugs are fine with me.
No.
Tallahassee's... I'm not unfamiliar with them, is what I'm saying. I'm sorry to say that.
I would say I am an edgier person now, but that's all drugs and raves aside. I've changed a bit, and I'm sorry if I'm not the same person you once knew, but I'm happier.
Oh, that makes me happy for you.
You look good.
You look good.
You look so good.
Oh my god, stop. No.
Okay, first time we've seen each other in what, like 12 years?
Oh my god!
And you're just gonna roll up here to lay dip in my face? Sit down, you bitch, sit down. Come on! These tables are hard to get.
No, I know it's Kava. I know we can't just like. I know these tables are in demand.
How you been? You been good? I know you're.
Okay.
You're over there, you're a consultant. I don't
really
know what that means.
I don't either. Everybody in DC is a consultant in some way. I'm fair to mid.
Like the salary range?
No, I mean emotionally.
Oh,
I mean, how are you though? Look at you, you're like a senior like VP or something.
VP? Yeah, no, I'm a senior VP of marketing over at Coleman, Coleman & Schwartz. I'm married, as you can see. I'm
can
sure you were
oh
going
to
comment on
that. Oh my god!
It's a
That's... Oh my god, I never would have thought.
About Coleman, Coleman & Schwartz or the whole married thing?
I mean, neither.
Just water would be great. Just water. Water.
Margarita?
Water and a margarita.
And what? And water too.
Coleman, Coleman, and Schwartz? You thought
I just said, look at your ring. It's like so big and it's so sparkly. And
yeah.
What do you mean? I'm just.
But look at you, consultant, fair to me.
Consulting!
Oh, man.
For the government!
For the what?
In DC, who would have thought?
What exactly does that entail? Are you telling people how to do their jobs better? Are you. Oh, no ice, actually. Could you just take it? Shit, I don't want any ice in this thing, but...
Okay, do you want your margarita on the rocks, or... Because there's already rocks in it.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Okay, I'll be right back with no water or no ice in your.
Look at you, you picky bitch.
Sorry, you just know I really like.
I know.
I think I get more.
Changed a bit. I mean, you seem happier, like more emotionally fulfilled.
I don't know about you, but like since I found a stable partner, a job where I feel respected, and I'm like a valuable member of the team, I feel like I'm really like the past 12 years.
It looks like you're pregnant too.
No, right? The pregnancy has been a breeze so far. I don't even feel like there's a kid in me. Like, I don't want a margarita because, you know.
You're pregnant.
Because I'm pregnant.
That's like,
I feel
bad
like,
for the baby.
I feel like I could get away with being a little bad. I won't. But
you,
I feel like I'm
really happy for you.
But it's been
really,
good.
It's good to reconnect with people and see.